Hey, good optometry morning. Dr. Michael Nelson, your YouTube eye doctor here today. And today I'm telling you what's so special about the MyoSmart spectacle lens for myopia management. And we're going to tell you what's so special about the lens and why you should consider getting it for your child. And we're going to start right now. So this lens was developed at the Hong Kong Polytechnic University, and they're the ones that designed this lens and did the research study on this lens. And then Hoya is the company that has marketed this lens, and it's marketed as the MyoSmart spectacle lens. Okay, so who is this lens designed for? The MyoSmart spectacle lens is designed for any kids that is myopic that you want to try to slow down the progression of that myopia. And so we refer to that process of slowing down the progression of myopia as myopia management. Okay, so let's talk a little bit about what myopia is. So myopia is a condition where the image is focused in front of the retina instead of on the retina, and as a result, things aren't clear. And the symptoms of myopia are that things in the distance are going to be blurry, but you can see things up close, and that's why it's sometimes referred to as nearsightedness. Now, to deal with myopia, we're going to use some type of spectacle lens that bends light to put it in focus on the retina. Okay, so then I'm going to suggest that there's two things that you want your spectacle lenses to do. Number one, we've done for hundreds of years, we want a spectacle lens that puts things in focus on the retina so your child can see well far away. Now, the second thing that I want you to start considering is probably new to you, and it's the area of myopic management. I want you to consider choosing a lens that might help slow down the progression of the myopia. And we now have lenses that might be able to do that. And so in the past, I used to tell my patients that if they have nearsightedness, there's nothing really they can do to slow down the progression or change it. It's kind of like your height. It's pre-programmed genetically that you're going to grow as tall as you're going to grow, and we can't really affect that. But that's not true anymore for myopia. Well, still, genetics is a huge and major component in how myopic someone's going to be. We now know that there are options that we can do to slow down the progression of that myopia. So this spectacle lens works on the theory of myopic defocus. So in order to understand this, you kind of need to understand the anatomy of the eyeball. And basically, when we're correcting myopia, we put things in focus on the area of the retina which deals with your central vision. And that's the area called the macula. And we can easily do that with a standard spectacle lens. Now, what's unique about the eyeball is that the eyeball is curved. And so when we use a standard lens, that puts it in focus on the back of the eye, on the macula, and so you can see things clearly. But in the peripheral part of the retina, it actually doesn't put it in focus on the retina. And so it actually focuses behind the retina, and that's called hyperopic defocus. And so the images in our peripheral retina aren't really in focus. Now, that really doesn't bother us very much because our visual acuity in our peripheral part of our vision is so poor that you don't really notice that defocus. However, that hyperopic defocus can be a stimulus for the eye to continue growing. Basically, if that image is focused behind the eyeball goes, wait, things aren't in focus. We need to keep growing to get that image in focus on the retina. But when that happens, it also grows at the back of the part of the eye and increases the amount of myopia. So what studies have shown is that if you put the eyes in a state of myopic defocus, meaning that if you purposely focus the image in front of the retina, then there's no longer that stimulus for the eye to increase and grow longer. And as a result, individuals' myopia doesn't tend to increase as much. However, the problem with that is if you don't have the image in focus on the retina, things are blurry in the distance. So how do you have a clear image in the distance but also reduce that progression of myopia? And so the way you do this is with something called simultaneous myopic defocus. And the technology used in this is called DIMS technology. And so DIMS is an acronym for Defocus Incorporated Multifocal Segments, but because that's a mouthful, we just refer to it as DIMS. And so basically what the DIMS technology does is it simultaneously puts images in focus on the retina to allow you to see clearly and put things in focus in front of the retina to prevent that stimulus for the eye to grow longer. This is a lens that has DIMS technology, and when you look at it and look at the appearance of the lens, this looks exactly like a standard spectacle lens. But what's unique about this has some incredible microscopic properties in the lens. So in the DIMS lens, you have a clear zone in the center of the lens that's 9.4 millimeters wide. And then surrounding that, there's a zone that's 33 millimeters wide that has the DIMS technology in it. And in this zone, there are hundreds of tiny lenses. And we call these lenses segments. And each of these segments is 1.03 millimeters in diameter. And each of these segments has a different power than the rest of the lens that's surrounding them. And so the relative power in these segments is plus 3.5 Doppler's compared to the rest of the lens. And so these segments will focus the image in front of the retina, while the zones in between these segments and around the segments and in the center zone, clear zone of this lens, they'll focus the image on the retina to allow you to see clearly. And so the ratio of areas that are clear to the areas that are that have myopic defocus are 50-50. And so the immediate question that many people have when we talk about this lens, so if these lenses are purposely putting things out of focus on my retina, won't things look blurry? And the answer is no. And the reason why is because your brain is incredibly good at filtering out things that are not in focus. And to prove it, there's an example that every single one of you have experienced. And what I'm talking about is a screen door. When you look through a screen door, what you'll notice is that when you look off in the distance through the screen door, brain filters out that screen door so you don't actually even notice that it's there and you just see the clear image in the distance. And so the same phenomenon happens when you use a MyoSmart spectacle lens. You notice things are clear in the distance, but you really don't notice that blurred effect that the DIMS technology is giving you. Okay, so let's get a little bit technical for a moment, tell you the parameters and the materials that this lens comes in. So this lens is available in only one material. It's available in 1.59 index, which is a polycarbonate material. This is the same material that's used in safety glasses. So this is a high impact resistant, so it's great for safety with kids. It's also a little bit thinner and a little bit lighter than a standard plastic lens, so you get that added benefit of the lens. This technology and material cannot be tinted, and it's not available in a transition material. So if you want a sunglass, you have to rely on clip-ons that you put over top of the frame. It has a very durable scratch-resistant coating, and it also comes with a premium anti-reflection coating that's oleophobic, that reduces smudges and fingerprints that might build up on the lens. And so the coating and the lens material both have UV protection in them, so this lens is 100% UV protective, even if you aren't wearing your clip-on sunglasses. It comes in a huge power range from plano to minus 10. It's up to, and it's available up to 4 diopters of SIL, and you can incorporate 3 diopters of prism into the lens. So if we talk about if there's any restriction on frames that you can use, and so there's really no restriction on which frame you can use except for one. What you need is the B size, which is the measurement from the top of the frame to the bottom of the frame. The B size has to be a minimum of 25 millimeters. And when you wear fit with this lens at your eye clinic, what they're going to do, they're going to measure where the center of your pupil is relative to the frame and also measure your monocular pupillary distance so they can make sure the center of this lens is fit perfectly to the center of your pupils. One thing that you need to keep in mind, this is a therapeutic lens, and so you won't find this at every clinic. Clinics that use this lens have to be certified in the use and the fit of this lens, and so you might have to ask specifically if your eye clinic carries the MyoSmart spectacle lens. All right, so here's a question that a lot of people are wondering. Does this lens actually work and is it effective? And I did a whole video summarizing the summary of that research. And if you want to look at that, I've got a card up top here and you can delve into the research on that. But let me give you the summary. On average, kids that are in a standard spectacle lens, their myopia will increase by 0.42 diopters every single year. Now, for a frame of reference, the smallest step that we can change a pair of spectacles is 0.25 diopters. And that's typically the amount that people will typically notice if things are blurry. If you have a 0.25 change in your prescription, you will often notice if you update your prescription, oh yeah, that's much clearer. A 0.25 diopter also seems to correspond to a line increase or decrease on the visual acuity chart. So what happens in the MyoSmart lens? And so in the MyoSmart lens, for the study for up to 3 years, they found that there was only a 0.17 increase in the myopia every year. So the studies on this lens only went out to 3 years. So we do have to extrapolate and make some guesses on how things are going to change. And obviously we don't know the future. We don't know how much an individual's prescription is going to change and when it's going to change and by how much it's going to change. But for argument's sake, let's use an example. Let's say your child has a prescription of minus 0.5 diopters. So what happens if that child's in a standard lens and it increases by 0.42 diopters every single year? If after 5 years, they're going to be about minus 2.5 diopters. Now, if you take the same child and you put them in the MyoSmart lens and it only changes by 0.17 diopters every year, their prescription is only going to be about minus 1.25 diopters, just a little bit over minus 1.25 diopters. And that's a significant difference. Now, it might not seem like a big difference on paper, but if you're someone that has a minus 250 diopter prescription, you'll notice that without your glasses, things are pretty blurry. You're not going to be able typically to drive a car, and you're going to typically wear your glasses all the time in order so that you can see things clearly. Now, on the other hand, if you're a minus 1.25 diopter prescription, in many cases you can drive a car safely without glasses. You can function in your world without glasses. Definitely glasses will make things much clearer, but it's a much different dependency on your glasses with those two prescriptions. Okay, so let's talk a little bit about the cost of this lens. So generally, you could expect to spend about $550 Canadian for a pair of lenses, and in the US, probably about $400 for a pair of lenses, and that doesn't include the cost of the frame. So this lens does come with a two-year manufacturer defect on the coatings, and it also has a guarantee that if your prescription increases by more than a half diopter in a given year, the company will change the lenses at no cost. All right, so should you use this, and is this lens worth it? Okay, so here's the thing. We don't know what your child's prescription is going to end up to be. We can't predict the future. We don't know how much it's going to change. We're not going to know when it's going to change. But what we do know is that we have some options that can possibly slow down the progression even a little bit. And the only reason not to use them is that they're a little bit more expensive. So here's the questions that I have for you. If there was some type of training program that you could put your child in that you could spend a few hundred dollars every year and it might make them a little bit better at a particular sport than their peers, would that be a worthwhile investment? Likewise, if there was some type of treatment that you could spend a few thousand dollars on that you could make sure that your kids had straight teeth when they were adults, would that be a worthwhile investment? If there is an option that can slow down how bad your child's prescription is going to get and how bad their eyesight is going to be as an adult, in addition, this will also reduce the likelihood of them developing eye diseases as an adult, including cataracts, glaucoma, retinal detachments. Is that a worthwhile investment? And I would argue that our vision is so important to us and so critical to us, both as kids and as adults. Investing in some type of myopic management to try to slow down any of the nearsightedness is a worthwhile investment. Okay, so if you have any other questions about the MyoSmart Spectacle Lens, leave a comment down below. If we get enough of those questions, I'll do another video on frequently asked questions. And if you want to see more videos about myopia management or other things to do with your eyes, make sure you hit the subscribe button so you can get updates on those videos. And with that, have a great optometry day.